Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
Oh my God, my baby. I'll never go back. My baby.
The mother of the victim embraces the mom of a suspect in that home invasion that left a Clemson University student dead. Good evening. Welcome. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. Three young men suspected of killing Stephen Gritch stood before a judge who soon called it one of the saddest events he's ever seen in a courtroom.
In that courtroom today, those young men came face to face with the parents of the Clemson student who was killed. News 4's Angela Rodriguez with more tonight from Pickens County.
Stephen Gritch walked into court with what was left of his son's bloody T-shirt tied around his wrist.
My son's blood.
His 23-year-old son and namesake was shot to death Saturday night in his off-campus apartment. In court, Mr. Gritch confronted three of the accused killers, Jordan Dalton and his brother Jaron Dalton, along with Bernard Ramsey.
Never. I hope you saw him laying there. He was shot laying on the ground. He was already laying on the ground doing what you guys asked him to do. Right? He was laying down. He never even got in a fight in his life.
Those words brought on an unexpected reaction from Ramsey's mother.
I know how y'all feel because I'm about to lose a son. And I just want y'all to know I'm sorry.
Ma'am.
I'm sorry. I can't explain it.
Thank you, ma'am.
But I'm sorry.
I don't wish grief on you.
Look at this picture, please. Help us find him. This is the trigger man that has killed my son, and he needs to be caught and brought to justice.
Both of those families today, as you could see, were united in sadness. They are losing their children, one to a grave, the other fear they're losing their children to prison. We also know that the man on the run tonight that authorities are looking for, his name is Lester Mosley Jr. And we are told that Gritch was not the intended target in this case. Investigators say the suspects were after his roommate, a suspected drug dealer who was arrested after that shooting Saturday night. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4, live in Pickens County.
Angela, thank you. We're covering a death investigation tonight in Greenville County. The coroner's office calls it homicide. Dispatchers got the call about a disturbance just before 2 this morning at a home on Lanford Drive. This is near Whitehorse and Augusta Roads. Deputies tell us they found a man dead inside the home there, and the deputy coroner says he also found shell casings and evidence of a shooting there as well. There's no official ID tonight, but the family of 51-year-old Joseph Kreit is coming forward saying it was, in fact, their father killed in the shooting, and they say it was done inside the home. They did not want to go on camera today, but neighbors did speak about Kreit's good nature.
Good guy, didn't bother nobody. He had just moved here like sometime in February, March, he had just moved there. He just clean guy.
If you have any information that may help with this case, you're asked to call Crime Stoppers at 23 Crime.
A shooting in Greenville County put an elementary school on lockdown this afternoon. Deputies tell us the shooting happened on Willis Avenue. They say a man approached a home and asked a couple he knew for money. A fight and a struggle took place between the two men. The suspect revealed a weapon and it was shot during the struggle. Deputies say the woman was shot in the hand. They say the suspect was also shot. We are told he then left on foot and got into a vehicle. School officials say the suspect was last seen in the Alexander Elementary parking lot, and the school was put on lockdown. Under deputy supervision, students were allowed to leave. If you have any information on this case, call Crime Stoppers. The number is 23 Crime.
We're now able to show you what happened during a police chase that ended with the crash that killed a man in Anderson County. News 4 first brought you the dash cam video on WYFF4.com. In that video, you see an Anderson County deputy trying to pull over a black Mustang. This is on Flat Rock Road. Investigators say the driver, Corey Madden, was in a stolen car. The Mustang is seen passing several cars and a pedestrian. The deputy eventually loses sight of the car and eventually comes up on a plume of dirt and debris in the air. Madden was ejected from the car on impact. He died there at the scene. The Highway Patrol is now investigating the wreck.
Policy and procedure issues will be reviewed to make sure the deputy was in line. And I believe at this point, you know, they feel pretty comfortable and confident that he was, but of course, all that is basically under review with both agencies.
There was a passenger inside that car, Tasha Foster. She was thrown from the wreckage as well. And tonight, investigators tell us she is paralyzed because of her injuries.
The woman accused of having a baby in a toilet at the Bilo Center is expected in court tomorrow. Officials are expecting Jessica Blackman to accept a plea deal. She was 24 years old when she delivered her baby boy in the bathroom stall in February of last year. Investigators say a cleaning crew found the baby in the toilet after more than an hour. She is charged with felony child abuse and unlawful neglect. She faces up to 20 years if convicted. However, the details of the plea deal have not been released.
This is the anniversary of a cold case the Cherokee County Sheriff's Office is still trying to solve. Today marks 16 years since Sheila Patterson Manley was found dead. Her body was lying off an exit ramp, in fact, ramp 100, there along I-85. Her case is classified as homicide. And today, deputies were out passing out flyers trying to generate leads. They plan to re-examine other evidence in the case as well. $2,500 in reward money is offered for information that leads to an arrest in this case. And if you can help, call Crime Stoppers at 1-888-CRIME-SC.
The investigation goes on into the fire that destroyed a business in Spartanburg County. Firefighters had to knock down the exterior of Plectronic Seals to get to the fire. The fire chief tells us the fire does not appear to be suspicious, but says he won't be certain until his investigation is over. He says the business, well, it's a complete loss. DHEC was also at the scene, but found no hazardous material threats to the public.
It was a surprise vote. Last night, Spartanburg City Council decided to close the Spartanburg Swim Center. Needless to say, there are a lot of people who are not happy about this. We're told it cost about $34,000 a month to run, maintain, and pay for staff there at the Swim Center. And that's money Linda Dogan of the City Council says the city simply does not have. But for some people, this is about much more than just a swim center.
I myself am 61 years old, and as a resident of Spartanburg, you're not going to see me in a skateboard park, on a basketball court, on a baseball field, or in an ice skating rink.
The most of the residents come from the county. If the county kicked in some money, District 7 school kicks in some money, then we'll be okay. But neither one of those options have happened.
So for now, the city says it will help members of the Spartanburg Swim Center pay for monthly memberships to the YMCA if they choose to do that. Some upstate elementary school students had an unforgettable assignment today.
They had to pull off a top secret surprise for their principal. News 4's Mike McCormick now with how they made the grade.
Oh, boy.
Surprise.
Dr. Chuck Bagwell learned a big lesson today. Students and staff at Arcadia Elementary can really keep a secret.
I did not expect this.
As the whole school watched, the executive director of the South Carolina Association of School Administrators surprised Bagwell, naming him South Carolina's Elementary School Principal of the Year for 2013.
Thank you doesn't even begin to describe my feelings for y'all. You're the most beautiful kids in the world. I tell people that every day.
His peers nominated him, and ultimately the selection committees gave him the highest score.
There are a lot of folks who want to bash public education, and I find that most of those who do that haven't stepped inside a school in a long time. They haven't really met the people who are there working every day.
Bagwell started here 10 years ago.
The first day I was here, it was obvious to me this is what God wanted me to be.
He calls this his mission field.
We try to do everything we can here from having clothes closets to food closets to setting up dental appointments and eye doctor's appointments and coats and shoes and things like that, because a hungry child doesn't care if they can read or write. A child who's cold don't care if they can read or write.
His goal is to always put a child's basic needs first, then focus on their education. It's a mission he accomplishes daily, and now it's no secret. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, Spartanburg.
Now, over the next year, Dr. Bagwell will go to Columbia and Washington, D.C. to be recognized for his leadership. He is the second District 6 principal to win the award in just the last few years.